One for the money, two for the Pharisees. Look here, we got two hams with extra glaze for you niggas. All right. Now I'm gonna get the first cut. Did you get it out? I want you to bring it in closer, closer. All right, we want that. We want to make sure we get some juice on the lens. Okay. Boy, look at that shit there. Man, look here, man. Y'all hate. Y'all know y'all want some of this. Y'all know y'all want some. I get first taste, y'all. Y'all see that there? It's sanctified by the word of God in prayer. All right? Praise it. All right? Everybody's in the line up and get their fill. All right? Want to give all praise to y'all by sitting my truck, Yahweh Shai. Any day that y'all want to celebrate Yahweh Shai Day, family, fuck these Pharisees, man. Let them talk all the shit they want. Y'all ain't coming to my house stopping shit. All right? I'll cook three hams the next damn time and some crab legs around it, you bitch ass niggas. All right. That's it, y'all. We're going to give all praise to Yahweh by sitting my truck, Yahweh Shai. Let's eat.
All right.
You got it. Y'all see the knife? Oh, y'all gonna love this.
Yeah, Shalom. This is St. John 9. St. John chapter 9. And verse 31. Now we know that the Mosai heareth not sinners. But if any man be a worshipper of the Most High and doeth his will, him he heareth. Kal halal wa chawad la abanawa wa banwa yahawa bahasham yahawa shai bahasham wa chaha kwadash. All praise, honor, glory to the Heavenly Father and His Son, whose name is Yahweh. Yah means He, and Hawa means to be or exist. Bahasham means in the name. Yahweh Shai, Yah means He, and Yahweh Shai means deliver or redeemer. He come to redeem and deliver the nation of Israel, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans. And double honor to mighty Jesus, the apostles, the elders, and the bishops of Great Millstone, who watch over our souls. Shalom to the Akim, who waited our sincere and serious doing the will of Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Bahasham, Bacha Ha Kodash. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 1 and 2. To you all, stay strong and stay mighty. Alright, so I'm the brother of the disciple Kosha Benyamin from the branch chain Great Millstone, Barbados. You know what? You heard him just quote the book of 1 Timothy 4. But I want you. Do I have another video of this Johnny come lately here? I guess I don't. Oh, there's it here.
I'm not gonna say another message day of edification because we finna eat around here. It's Yahweh Shai Day again, all right? We want to give all praises to Yahweh Shai. All praises due. We dedicate this day every time we come together. We dedicate the time that we come together to our son and brother that gave his life on the cross for the redemption of Israel. All praises. Before we get started, just want to bring out a quick precept. This is 1 Timothy 1 and 4. Now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils, speaking lies and hypocrisy, having their conscience seared with a hot iron, forbidding to marry and commanding to abstain from meats with the power have created to be received with thanksgiving of them which believe and know the truth. For every creature of the power is good, and nothing to be refused if it be received with thanksgiving, for it is sanctified by the word of power and prayer. All praises to Yahweh by Shema Mashiach Yahweh Shai. Let's give it up for the Father. Barakatai Yahweh, Barakatai Yahweh Shai, Barakatai Yahweh,
All right, so you heard him read the book of 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 1. There's history behind the book of Timothy, Corinthians, Ephesians, Galatians, etc. Paul did not write or preach anything different to what our Lord Yahweh Shai or the ancient prophets did. He did not go against what was already written. You gotta understand what's happening here in the book of Timothy. You see? You gotta go all the way back to Corinthians. You see? So let me just read it again. 1 Timothy 4, verse 1. Now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils, speaking lies in hypocrisy, having their conscience seared with an hot iron, forbidden to marry. And always, when always bypassing this part, forbidden to marry. Well, you should tell the man don't get the woman then, or you should tell the women don't get the man then. We want to always skip in this part, but anyhow, forbidden to marry and commanded to abstain from meats which the Most High have created to be received with thanksgiving of them which believe and know the truth. That is the key part in this chapter here. Let me read it again, right? Forbidden to marry. So you got men tell you, listen, don't deal with a woman, big man. Or you got men tell you, telling a woman, don't deal with a man. Is that right? That way in 1 Corinthians 7, the Apostle Paul said, if you're burning, go and get a husband or go and get a wife. You see? You got men come and tell you different. Like you got the nuns. You got nuns. You know what I mean? Going against the faith. Right? The knowledge that we've gained through Hamashiach Yahweh Shai. But let me continue, right? Forbidden to marry and commanded to abstain from meats which God have created to be received with thanksgiving of them which believe and know the truth. Right? For every creature of the Most High is good and nothing to be refused if it be received with thanksgiving, for it is sanctified by the word of the Most High and prayer. Now you can't clean unclean food with prayer. So what is verse 3, 4, and 5 talking about? We got to go back now. Let me get Psalms 119. You just can't read. You see, what happened is that, I noticed with that with that Babylonian, that's what we can call him. He hasn't gotten away from his demon, which is basically food. You see? And which is basically that unclean food. He hasn't gotten away from that. He hasn't been cleansed from that. You see? He hasn't gotten over that hurdle. You see? He knows he's an Israelite. But when it comes to giving up the things in this world that made you sin against the Most High, it seems to be have a stronghold on them. You see? Psalms 119, verse 142. Thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and thy law is the truth. So you go back to Timothy, right? Of them which believe and know the truth, which is what? Going back to the law, correct? But let me get to the main point here. Now, when you read 1 Corinthians, the 8th chapter, right, is a history going on here, right? Commanded to abstain from meats. 1 Timothy 4, verse 3. Psalms chapter 111 and verse 10. The fear of Yahweh Bahashem Yahavashai is the beginning of wisdom, a good understanding of all there that do his commandments, his prayers endure forever. A good understanding of all there that do his commandments. So you're clearly seeing reprobates out there that do not have good understanding. They just read that precept and thinking that, yeah, you know what I mean? We can eat what we want to eat. Correct? No, you're incorrect. So again, about the Corinthians. Let me go to Corinthians again. You got a word strain. Because this topic here is be lengthy. Is right? Because it goes into the history of what the Apostle Paul was telling Timothy when he was in Corinth. Right? The Israelites that was in Corinth. In fact, let me go. Right? It says, right. Now, when we go to Leviticus, it gives you the law, etc. So, let me go. I want to get to the point. 1 Corinthians 8 and 1 Corinthians 10. Meats offered unto idols. Right? So, what you don't understand is, let me get it. 1 Corinthians 8 verse 1. Now, as touching things offered unto idols, we know that we all have knowledge. Knowledge puffeth up, but charity edifieth. And if any man think that he knoweth anything, he knoweth nothing yet as he ought to know. But if any man love the Mosai, the same is known of him. As concerning, therefore, the eating of those things that are offered in sacrifice unto idols, we know that an idol is nothing in the world, and that there is none other God but one. So the Apostle Paul was telling the brothers in Corinth, listen, you see, these heathens, when they're sacrificing these meats unto their gods, we all know that, look, them gods is a waste of time. Psalm 96 verse 5, let me get that. Psalm 96 verse 5. Psalm chapter 96 and verse 5. For all the gods of the nations are idols, but Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahavashai made the heavens. They are nothing. They are absolutely nothing. Today the Apostle Paul was telling the brothers in Corinth, I ain't done yet, right? It says, for though there be that are called gods, right, whether in heaven or in earth, as there are gods many and lords many, but to us, they are gods many and lords many, because these heathens got their imagination. But remember, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahavashai is only in the midst of Israel. We are the ones close. We are the ones united with Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahavashai, not these heathens. So they had a conjure in their figment of their imagination, their own gods to feel important. So that way you get Buddha. That way you get Jesus Christ, Esau, Edom's God. Right? You got Selassie. Although that was created by our brothers, the Benjamin brothers, right? Because they didn't have no knowledge of the truth. It's right. Goes back to Ethiopia. Then you got what? Hindu god Shiva with the locks. Many other gods, right? Let me continue here. For though there be that are called gods, whether in heaven or in earth, as there are gods many and lords many, but to us there is but one power, the Father, of whom are all things, and we in him, and one Lord, Yahweh Shai HaMashiach, by whom are all things, and we by him. Howbeit, there is not in every man that knowledge. For some, if conscious of the idol, unto this hour eat it as a thing offered unto an idol, and their conscience being weak is defiled. But meat commendeth us not to the Most High, for neither if we eat, are we the better, neither if we eat not, are we the worse. So what Apostle Paul was saying here, let me go on now to the commentary here, right? What the Apostle Paul was saying was, look, big man, a man might, okay, I can go use the bigger ups for example. You got the apostles right now. The Apostle Tahar, Apostle Gabar, Apostle Ariamla, Apostle Wakar, and the bishops on now, the higher men in the ministry. These men don't know a lot. Listen, big man, when you go to these meat shops, supermarkets, right, the way these heathens is preparing the meat, and just do it in the honor of their gods, right? These men don't know, well, look, them meats ain't nothing, them gods ain't nothing. So they're going, boy, the lawful meats, really, I just read it, that to them that know the truth, right? Because even in, even sacrifice lawful meats, chicken, etc., these heathens, right, to their gods. Or I get this meat, I get a good catch today. Praise be, you know what I mean? And they will call their God's name. You see? Good. These men don't know, well, look, that ain't nothing. We can go and give thanks to Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai, because these men on a higher level. Younger brothers coming in now, right? Ain't got that understanding yet. Today the Apostle Paul was saying here, look, man, now concerning things offered to others, we know that we all have knowledge. Knowledge puffs up, but love edifies. And if anyone thinks that he knows anything, he knows nothing yet as he ought to know. But if anyone loves the Mosai, this one is known in him. Now concerning things offered to others, having dealt with their questions about marriage and singleness, again, I just read that in that, when you go to Timothy, right? When you go to Timothy, tell you shouldn't get married, etc. But nobody want to address that. Anyhow, it says, having dealt with their questions about marriage and singleness, Paul now addresses in 1 Corinthians chapters 8 and chapters 10 the next of their questions regarding eating meat that has been sacrificed to idols. That is the point in what Timothy was saying. 1 Timothy 4 and 2, speaking lies and hypocrisy, having their conscience seared with hot iron, forbidden to marry and commanded to abstain from meats. Right, because these meats was being offered to idols. These heathens was offering these meats unto idols. So the man was saying, man, you gonna really eat that idea when I get offered to Dagon? Kind of you can really eat that idea when I really get offered to Buddha. You know what I mean? Man, you should look, man. You shouldn't do that. You shouldn't do that. You ain't seduced. Don't mind. You know what I mean? So the men that got higher understanding, no, well, look, that's a waste of time. These guys is a waste of time. So the Apostle Paul was telling Timothy that they got men that can come and tell you, well, look, man, all they did get sold in the shambles. Like they got some of these rasta men and tell you, right? You hear that idea, big man? You know what's getting do with that idea? This is 34th. Yeah, we know that there's how these heathens prepare these meats. You could say the same thing with vegetables, though. But what are you supposed to do? Starve? I can pray over my food, give Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai thanks, and his will be done. It's simple. You see? It says, things offered to idols. The meat offered on pagan altars was usually divided into three portions. One portion was burnt in honor of the god. One portion was given to the worshiper to take home and eat. And the third portion was given to the priest. If the priest didn't want to eat his portion, he sold it at the temple restaurant or meat market. The meat served and sold at the temple was generally cheaper than as well as now. People love a bargain, right? Things over the idols. The issue raised many questions for the Corinthian Christians, Israelites. Can we eat meat purchased at the temple meat market? What if we are served meat purchased at the temple meat market when we are guests in someone's home? Can a Christian Israelite eat at the restaurant at the pagan temple? We know that we all have knowledge. Instead of talking about food, Paul first talks about the principles of knowledge and love. Israelite behavior is founded on love, not knowledge. Meaning, you don't boast at yourself because you know this, you know that. Is right? That way he tells you in Galatians, if any man thinks he knows something, he knows nothing. Is right? And the goal of the Christian life is not knowledge, but love. Knowledge puffs up, but love edifies. Both knowledge and love have an effect on our lives in that each of them make something grow. The difference between puffs up and edifies is striking. It is the difference between a bubble, a building. Some Christians grow, others just swell. If anyone thinks that he knows anything, if we think we know it all, we really don't know anything. We're not allowed. Understanding the reality of the idols meat is offered to. So, long story short, what the Apostle Paul was telling Timothy is, look, They're going to got men that can come and tell you, don't eat this, don't eat that, because it get offered in these temples to their god, the fish god, you know what I mean, etc. But the apostle Paul tell Timothy, look, don't mind these men. We already know the truth. We already have the truth. We know that there's one God and one mediator. So don't mind these men. Is that right? Therefore, concerning the eating of things offered to idols, we know that an idol is nothing in the world, and that there is no other power but one. For even if there are so-called gods, whether in heaven or in earth, because there is only one true power, idols are not competing gods. Idols are therefore nothing in the world and are only so-called gods. Example, if meat is offered to Zeus, there is no real Zeus. There is no other god but one, which is Yahweh. You see? Like, so in the shambas, you know, in the butcher shops, the cold storage shops go and get, I'm using modern day time here, right? The butcher shops, you know what I mean? You again, good. See how this pig grow there? This pig grow fat and healthy. Praise be! You know, call out God's name, right? Chicken, turkey, you name it, right? Good. Cold storage shops, come and take them up, package them, candy supermarkets. We go in the supermarket now to purchase the ones that in the truth, lawful meats. Is that right? Although the same lawful meats was honored and praised to the heathen's gods, but we know better. Is that right? If meat is offered to Zeus, there is no real Zeus. There is no other god but one. He is only one if the soul, he is only one of the so-called gods. There are many images that are supposed to be representations of divinities, but these divinities are nothing. The figments of mere fantasy. That's a precept. What's that? So lock here a minute. That's a precept. Wisdom of Solomon 31. Surely vain are all men by nature who are ignorant of the Most High and cannot out of the good things that are seen know him, that is, neither by considering the works did they acknowledge the workmaster, but deem either fire or wind or the swift ear or the circling of the stars or the violent water or the lights of heaven to be the gods which govern the world, with whose beauty, if they being delighted, took them to be gods, let them know how much better the Lord of them is. For he, for Salakia, for the first order of beauty, have created them. You see, that's Yahweh, while Yahweh Shai. But if they were astonished at their power and virtue, let them understand by them how much mightier he is that made them. How mightier Yahweh that made them. That what he is mean, Yahweh. You understand? For by the greatness and beauty of the creatures, proportionably the maker of them is seen. And then there's another one. Wisdom of Solomon 14, verse 12. For the devising of idols was the beginning of spiritual fornication, and the invention of them the corruption of life. You see that? For neither were there from the beginning, neither shall there be forever. For by the vain glory of men they entered into the world, and therefore shall there come shortly to an end. See? You see that? So going back to the commentary, right? There are many images that are supposed to be representation of divinities, but these divinities are nothing. The figments of mere fancy, and these images have no corresponding realities. Plain. Is that right? We are close to Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh. He chose us, not these heathens. So therefore, they can create gods in their own fake in their world, be Buddha, Zeus, release the Kraken. You know, you know what I mean? He kind of has sex with women. And he get a child now. You know what I mean? Half man, half God. You know what I mean? Come on, man. So it's history behind 1 Timothy 4, I may call it that. It's history behind 1 Timothy 4, right? 1 to 3. to four, right? The Corinthian Christians may have reason like this. If idols are really nothing, it must mean nothing to eat. It must mean nothing to eat. Meat sacrifice to nothing idols, and it must mean nothing to eat. Let me read that again. If Corinthian Christians may have reason like this. If idols are really nothing, it must mean nothing to eat meat sacrifice to nothing idols. And it must mean nothing to eat in the buildings used to worship these nothing idols. You see that? In the following section, Paul will show them a better way. Not all have the same knowledge. Right, however, there is not in everyone that knowledge. For some, if conscious of the idol, until now, eat it as a thing offered to an idol, and their conscience being weak is defiled. There is not in everyone that knowledge. The Corinthian Christians who felt free to eat at the pagan temple may have based their freedom on correct knowledge. They have the truth, knowing that idols are nothing, you see? But for some, they have conscience of the idol, and they eat meat sacrificed to the idol as a thing offered to an idol. So these ones didn't get really like the full understanding yet, you see? The Apostle Paul had to grow up the men, you know what I mean? Take your time with them. Just like being circumcised, he didn't rush the men to go and get circumcised. There was that law, there was that council. Man, you can't get saved unless you get circumcised. Paul said, man, what strain? You got to tell them first, I've seen from blood, I've seen from idols, etc. Let them get built up in the spirit. Then they will get circumcised. You see anything here, big man? Not that, look, there's meat, there's lawful meat. You understand? If you go back to the law, there's meat you shouldn't eat. It's right? Now, these heathens sacrificing their temples and their butcher shops, etc., to their God. They give thanks to their God. But we don't know that's a waste of time. So don't worry about that. It's right? Stick with the basics first. You know what I mean? Paul asked the Corinthian Christians who know there is nothing to an idol to remember that not everyone knows this. And if someone believes there is something to an idol and they eat meat that has been sacrificed to an idol, their conscience being weak is defiled. What is their conscience considered weak? Not because their conscience doesn't work. Indeed, it does work. In fact, it overworks. Their conscience is considered weak because it is wrongly informed. Their conscience is operating on the idea that there really is something to an idol. You see? You see that? You can imagine the free Corinthian Christians with their superior knowledge saying, but we are right. And in this case, being right is important, but it is not more important than showing love to the family of the Most High. So yeah, man. In Acts 15:29, the Jerusalem Council sent a letter commanding some churches to, among other things, abstain from things offered to idols. But Paul's discussion of the issue here does not contradict what the Jerusalem Council decided in Acts 15. Instead, it shows that the council's decision was not intended to regulate all the church all the time. It was a temporary arrangement meant to advance the cause of the gospel among the Jews of that day. So look, man, the Apostle Paul was telling the men, look, everything cool. Pray to Yahweh by Hashem, because we know there's one power. One mediator, all these idols here that these heathens reference and who the sacrifice the fools to is a waste of time. So 1 Timothy 4:1. Now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith. So they're gonna leave the truth. They're gonna leave the understanding of things you should eat, things you should not eat. Idols being sacrificed in temples, etc. They're gonna leave all of that. Right? Giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils, speaking lies in hypocrisy, having their conscience seared with a hot iron, forbidden to marry, and commanded to abstain from meats, which the Most High have created to be received with thanksgiving of them which believe and know the truth. Going back to the law, Leviticus 11, Deuteronomy, etc. Isaiah 66 and 3, Isaiah 65 and 3, Malachi 3 and 6, 2 Peter 3. I mean, come on, man. It's right. Yeah, I can shut this up there, man. Is that? You know what I mean? Quite goes on to know, you know what I mean? It goes on to more that you got this understanding. You know what I mean? So don't make your brother weak through your understanding. You gotta break it down to him, build him up. Is that? So yeah, boy, don't mind that, man. Right? That is a seducing spirit there, big man. Don't mind that, man. Right? Therefore, if food makes my brother stumble, it will never again eat meat. Paul makes the principle clear. Our actions can never be based only on what we know to be right for ourselves. We also need to consider what is right toward our brothers and sisters in Yahweh Shai. So, yeah, you know, like some brothers want to be vegetarians because they don't like the way how animals get killed. You know what I mean? They got that real, like, pet peeve to see how animals get treated, get slaughtered for the meat, is that? So they say, man, I can't deal with that, man. So they stick to being vegetarians, but don't let our brother, he tell you that too, don't let our brother judge the brother that eating the meat. No, don't let the brother eating the meat judge the brother that ain't eating the meat. Food don't make you better, you know what I mean? To the more say, is that? Is your faithfulness to Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, you know what I mean? It's like it just that one brother understands, well, look, this meat, right? The Lord created all things. I eat meat, I like meat, lawful meats like that, you know what I mean? These heathens, we gotta go to the heathens for one of all things, right? Deuteronomy 28 chapter, it's like for the one of all things, and these heathens can prepare the meat, they can do it in the name of their gods, but we know that their gods are nothing. If the idol was offered to Zeus, we know that Zeus is nothing. Is that? So we got that knowledge, well, like we can pray to Yahweh Bashem Yahushai to water for this food. The brother know that he shouldn't be looking down the brother. He won't eat the meat. So the brother is a vegetarian, oh man. Yeah, you understand that. But even the brother is a vegetarian during the Passover. If he in the faith, he has to eat the Passover lamb. He has to eat it. It's commanded. You see? So if for the 11 months, he ain't want to eat the meat, no problem. But when he passed, if it come wrong, he or she has to eat that meat. You see? But if he can't judge his brother for eating meat. You see? Because his brother know, well, look, there's not another waste of fucking time. I give you Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai Tai. That what it means. It is sanctified. 1 Timothy 4. And verse 4, for every creature of God is good, and nothing to be refused, if it be received with thanksgiving. See? For it is sanctified by the word of the Most High and prayer. Right, so the same creatures, the same meat, right, that these heathen sacrifice unto, give praise unto, when we pray over it, basically that's the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, you know what I mean? Overpowering these heathen gods when they pray over their fools and they give thanks to their idols, their gods. Our power is stronger and greater. So when we pray over it, it's sanctified, cleansed, you know what I mean? So whatever issues they dealt with it, how they prepared it, right? It ain't gonna be detrimental to we. Why? Because we give Yahweh Bashem Yahushai thanks, man. You won't want to understand, man. I really hope I don't understand, man. You know what I mean? Hey, Kah Halal Yahweh Bahashem Yahushai, Bahashem Kah Kodash, for this understanding, this knowledge, this truth. You know what I mean? And double honor to my teachers, the apostles, the elders, and the bishops of Great Millstone. Shalom.